Hi, my name's Richard Chambry. This is RICHFOTO Books. It's my photo vlog series where I'm featuring my photo book collection, hopefully giving a little bit of inspiration for photographers out there if they're starting out or already established to go and purchase some books themselves and hopefully take these reviews on board. So this is today's book, which is Stephan Schmidt, Uncommon Places. It's originally published in 1982. It's a slightly updated version. They filled it up with some more images, and it's basically Stephan Schmidt, photographer. He basically got in his car in 1973 and drove across America and was photographing the urban landscapes, which is a shortened version of the story because we haven't got too long. So Stephan Schmidt, just to give you a little bit of a background, he got started very early in photography. He had images accepted in from MoMA with Edward Steichen, and from there went and was involved in the factory with Andy Warhol, and then took off and did this this large journey and started a new way of photographing the landscape for me. I found him very influential in what he does or what he did. You can actually go and find him online. He's pretty active. He's got his own Instagram account now, and yeah, he's pretty cool with putting up new work and that kind of thing. So let's start going through it. It's a bit heavy, so excuse me while I try and get to the first page, because I marked out some pages already. So as there we go. Right. So what I really love is that they're not traditional. It's not traditional framing of an image. He's not really looking at making things pretty. And I especially like what he did in this book. He was photographing a lot of interiors, a lot of interiors of restaurants, a lot of interiors of the Holiday Inns he was staying in. He was also, you know, basically photographing car parks and stuff like that. So I really have been like quite influenced by that. I like that kind of photography and that kind of documentary kind of that documentary work. Not to mention the quality of it is fantastic. I couldn't tell you exactly which camera he's using, but I dare say it's I did read that he was using 5.4 camera. He's been using medium format. It's obviously medium format, some of it. Let's have a flick through. Okay, so this gives you a great example of the US landscape, and especially here, what I've noticed, especially on Instagram, is a great barometer for what people are interested in, what people are photographing and looking at. There's a lot of iconography, logos, road signs, very modern architecture. And as you can see here, I mean, like I said, that he took off in 1973. These were actually shot in 1974. These are out in Maine, which is, and this is Maine as well. So, you know, he's gone from state to state. The landscape is always changing, and he's able to photograph it in such a way that, you know, he wouldn't have traditionally gone to a state where you would come up with that stereotypical photograph of the state's landscape. This is in Saskatchewan, which is Canada. As you can see, you know, he's photographing new modern blocks and cars, and these have become very, obviously, very nostalgic. 1974, my God, that's nearly as old as me now. And here, these are in Texas. So, you know, he's taken what we now see. There's lots of derelict photography, derelict buildings photography. It's very, very popular. And, you know, he was doing this back then. This is 40 years ago. I especially love the colour, you know, and he's taken a great pride in framing and making sure that the images of a high quality. There aren't actually any words or captions as such. They're just locations, so I can't really tell you much more about the image itself because he hasn't dropped any comments on. This again is in Texas. Also in this book, there's quite a few portraits, and the portraits are also fantastic. You know, he's not just going around photographing buildings and landscapes. He's got a great eye, and he's got a great rapport with people. As you can see here, you know, as the US landscape's changing and becoming more modern, you know, flyovers are becoming a new thing, and he's out there photographing it. These are especially popular online now, you know, old signs, old motels, anything to do with road trip photography. Let's just pull that out there because I think you'll like this. This basically was, when I was growing up, everyone's mum looked like that. So that's a bit of nostalgia for me. He's such a, you know, the composition that's gone into this photography is fantastic. You know, and he's also what you would, you know, would you call that a street photography photo? You know, even or if it is, you know, if it is or if it isn't, you know, that's, he's using a cumbersome camera and he's framing it up, and you know, he's actually photographing people. You can't often dictate to people where they stand and what they do or can they move, you know, before you know you can't, and then move this huge camera around. It's very difficult. So he's managed to do that. And there's some amazing, another amazing portrait there. Lee Kramer, Bel Air, Maryland. There we go. So, you know, I really recommend this book. If you're interested in, I think if you're interested in street photography and if you're interested in landscape photography, it's a great book to go and get. There's also some good interview piece at the end. That's worth a read as well. It gives you a bit of an idea of a little bit of his influence and what he felt about it at the time. I seem to get from it that he got a bit of sick of life on the East Coast in New York and got in the car and just took off, you know, just to go and sort of clear his mind, as a lot of young people did in America. You know, that's where the road trip really comes from. So I really recommend this book. Check the links underneath. I'm going to drop a load of information for you where you can go find it. Go and find Stephan Schmidt. I'll drop links about Stephan Schmidt and where you can go and have a look at him. He's really cool. And if you'd like to go follow me, find me on Facebook, Instagram and Twitter. Bit of Snapchat as well, at RICHFOTO. I'll put the links underneath the video. Please do leave some likes and comments. Recommend some books and get the conversation going.